Hello and welcome to another edition of Tackle Talk. As always, five items, we're going to run the rule through them and tell you exactly what we think about them. Right then, Dan, I went first last time. Your turn to go first this time.
First up, a rod that I actually live tested for Angling Times back in January.
Drennan.
Drennan Acolyte commercial 10-foot feeder. Now this, oh, really is a lovely rod. They retail for just over the £200 mark, so it's a high-end rod, but it's not into the silly money. And take a look at the blank on that. How thin
is
that?
Slim, isn't it? That is very slim.
I've had a little bit of a look around. I'm pretty confident they are the slimmest blanks on the market. I've not come across anything slimmer than that.
And it's a commercial rod as well, isn't it? Yeah. It's not a silverfish rod.
That's around about half the diameter of a 5 pence piece.
Wow.
The width of that blank. That's absolutely ridiculously thin. So, the Acolyte range, there's a number of different rods out there in the Acolyte range. They're all staying, you know, your pluses and your ultras. This is an addition to it. It was designed by 5 times world champion Alan Scotthorn. Are you allowed to actually say his name without saying the word five times?
No, no, definitely not, Mr. Five okay. Times. You don't have to say Alan Scotthorn, just say five yeah. times.
So what he was looking at is a rod specifically for commercial work, method feeder work, casting to islands, stuff like that. So it's a couple of changes he made. He's shortened the tips down a little bit to the rest of the Acolyte range. That's allowing him to do harder, lower, punchier casts yep. that you're trying to do to islands, you know, when you're trying to get it nice and low, out the wind, under any foliage on the far bank. He's increased the guide size, so despite...
I couldn't help but notice, it looks huge.
Yeah, well, it looks even bigger because the blank's so thin.
You've got absolutely. This
seriously, seriously thin blank with these huge, great big guides. His thinking on that is, in summer, you're going to want to put 8 pound line through that when you're really, really bagging. That causes an awful lot of drag through the guides.
Absolutely.
So it's really increased the guide size on that as well.
So having played with it, having landed carp, did you feel it was up to the job with such a fine blank?
Oh, it's superb. You wouldn't have thought so, that the blank was so thin. The action feels exactly the same as any other rod out there. Just, it's lovely and light in your hands. It's fine. It cuts through the wind. It doesn't bounce around on your wrist so much as the wind goes through it. It's just superb rod to fish with. Really enjoyed it.
And that was a proper snag pit you went on as well. Oh, yeah. So if you can land carp with it on that, I think you'd be all right in general swims.
So yeah, real nice set of rods. A great addition to the Acolyte range. Check these out. I believe they're already in shops.
Excellent. Lovely. Nice
start. You got
start.
An item for me?
Nice start. Right, I'm going to go with my little item to start with. So small, it fits in the drawer. What we have here is an LM Products weed cutter, which is Lee Murphy who makes them. Now, these are a great idea. As you can see, we've got an island behind us today. A few bits and pieces. And you know how annoying it can be, Dan.
Yep.
The tiniest bit of grass, the tiniest bit of reed can prevent you from fishing an area. With this?
Well, yeah, every time you lift your pole, you just kind of loop a line over the top of it.
And it's always where you want to get it in.
Yeah,
and it can be the smallest thing. Now, with these beauties, they can be made to go on either your cupping kit or to go on your landing net handle. Now, you're probably thinking all cupping kits are different. Lee can make them to fit. So whatever cupping kit you've got, he can get the fitting to go in with it. He does 4 different styles. We've got like a V one, we've got some flat ones, depending on what you're trying to achieve or depending on how you prefer to cut it. And they range from 20 to 30 quid.
Yeah.
No website, we're going old school. Just get in touch with Lee on Facebook. You'll find it's Lee Murphy. You'll see I have loads of hundreds of angling friends, probably mutual friends. And if you send him your details, he'll get these out to you. Ultra sharp, but got a cover to prevent you from, you know, cutting yourself open because you really would on those. And just, as I've said, it just helps you tidy swims up, helps you have a great day's fishing without having to worry. And I think behind us is a great example. You know, there's bits of twigs and things, and that's just a normal commercial swim. And I think just to put in the side of your box for when you're facing that scenario.
Excuse me, Dan.
Thank you.
That it's spring.
These would be brilliant. And as I said, 4 different types. away.
What I really like about that, even does replacement blades for them as well. You undo the little screws, pop the replacement blades in. It does a version that fits a landing net handle as well, so the guys fishing the rivers, you know, want to cut a little hole out to fish. Yeah, really like those.
Awesome.
Great products, aren't they?
Lee Murphy, that's your man. Get in touch with him. Back at you.
How about some N-Gage Supernatural Line? Now, despite the name, it's not designed just for natural waters. It's an extra strong, low diameter line. They're thinking more hook lengths for this. It's slightly different material than their other lines. What is it, the standard?
The N-Gage. The N-Gage as it is, because...
It's not replacing the N-Gage. The N-Gage is still there for, like, your commercial fishing, like your main lines, you know, where you want something really, really durable. What they're thinking with this is, it's described as a very kind of grippy line due to the kind of the stretch and the way it knots. Absolutely ideal for spade end hooks.
Yeah.
And not just for natural fishing as well. The Guru team, they used it out on the Walterland Masters in massive thick sizes, with like size 10 hooks and ridiculous stuff like that for catching big carp.
I was going to say, because it comes in proper sizes there. I mean, you get all 18, and what does it go up to? It's on the back of the box?
Oh, 0.26, which is £12.10.
Proper animal gear, that, isn't it? So it's certainly not just a finesse line, is it? It's but again, those little bits and pieces, if your line slips on your hook, you know, that's a fish lost, and getting down to the nitty-gritty of just fine-tuning things and...
Well, this is really going to appeal to the cynical angler out there, because there's always the guys that say every pole comes out the same factory, every rod comes out the same factory, line, it's all the same, comes out the same factory. Well, if that's true, you're going to be buying this, aren't you? Because for £6 you get 150 metres, which makes it mega value. So even if you're not sold on the properties of it, if you're tight as anything, you guys are going to want to buy this as well.
Absolutely. Love it. Nice. Next. What have I got next? So, it's my turn to do two this time. We have got brand new reels from Daiwa. Now, if you're just looking at them, you probably think we've seen these before. Daiwa Ninjas. Now, these things, the first generation, sold like hotcakes. Mm. For the price that they were out there, absolutely phenomenal reels. Now, these ones are the LT. These are aimed at sort of lure fishing. Although I can imagine, having looked at them, that they are going to be all-rounders and quite versatile. They've got quite a quick retrieve. They've got the instant anti-reverse. So you've always got to be in touch when you're lure fishing. So that otherwise you don't set the hooks.
Yeah, yeah.
So there's no... Do you remember the old schools? You used to find like a quarter inch at drop
back. A
little
wobble, isn't it?
And you end up with that little bit of, you know, slack. You lose a perch or a pike.
It's all about the feel, isn't it? You want to be able to feel exactly what your lure's doing. So everything's as direct as possible. You feel all that through the rod, through the reel.
Exactly.
That's the real important stuff for lure fishing. And I like the way that they've tailored this version of the Ninjas directly at the lure.
And the great thing is that they've recognised that lure fishing isn't just lure fishing. There are so many areas of it. There's light lure fishing with tiny little rubber lures. There's big crankbaits. So they start from this one, which is the tiny 2000 size, go all the way up to the biggest 6000 size, and there's another five in the middle. So there's seven sizes covering everything. So, you know, plenty of cranking power, well made.
Being a Ninja, they're going to be a good price as well, aren't they?
Well, you're looking about £75 for the SRP. Nice. So, I mean, the RRP, I think, is 90, but you never pay the RRP. So you're looking about £75. So they are a little bit more than the original Ninjas, but I always thought the original Ninjas, that the price didn't do them a service.
They were kind of silly cheap,
they were stupidly cheap. Absolutely they were. I always thought they were a reel that were worth more than they were. I think this is perfectly fair. They're going to do a job. It's got all the details on the spool as to how much braid they'll take, how much nylon they'll take. So for example, on the 6000, it tells you for 0.40 and 0.30 nylon, and it tells you for 0.22 braid how much it'll take. So there's plenty of detail on there. They're going to sell really well. I can tell, really well made. bay alarm clicks in shops now. The LTs are in shops now. And the great thing is you're paying the same price as you are for the smaller one as you are for the bigger one. So potentially you're getting a little bit more for your money with the 6,000 in the bigger sizes.
Right.
Identical price though, so about 75 quid. And just really well made. And you know, with Daiwa reels, and particularly the Ninjas, if sold so well, you're going to be getting a great reel for your money.
Shall I show you another Daiwa product?
Hit me with it. They have had a launch fest recently, haven't they?
They've launched a lot of gear on the way.
They have.
So another addition to the Matchman range. So it's a nice little bag, but obviously most bags, they can get crushed when you're carrying them around. So it comes with two little plastic trays.
Brilliant.
So that's ideal size, I'd say, for pole floats, really. That's what I reckon I'd keep in there.
You put anything in the feeders, bombs, hook length packets, whatever.
You say that. Pellet wagglers as well, that's the perfect kind of size. Any little bits and pieces, feeders. But yeah, it's not absolutely groundbreaking. It just does a good job, doesn't it? Nice, solid trays.
And again, if you've got the Matchman range of luggage or rods or whatever, complements it, because we all know what anglers are like. We turn up, we see the colour scheme, we're all guilty of it. We've all got our colour scheme, we've all got a sort of brand that, you know, our luggage matches to, and that's another one that goes to it. Like I said, not every product's got to be groundbreaking, but as you've said, the hard shell of it keeps your kit safe.
It just does a good job for a sensible price. We're talking $17.99 for one of those, you can't get any cheaper these days,
can you? You know, we're in a day and age where you used to pick things up for a tenner, but I can't get a penny sweet for a tenner these days. So,
all right, Mr. 1996.
I remember a 10p mix, and it used to be a 2p for the sherbet dip. But anyway, enough about that. But yeah, a great item, and five again, in and out. As always, guys, if you've seen anything out there that you want us to have a look at, put a message in the comments. We will get in touch with the manufacturers and do our best to look at it. Doesn't have to be massive, doesn't have to be tiny. If there's something you're genuinely not sure about, put it down in the comments and we will do our best to get it on Tackle Talk in the future. But for now, thanks for watching and we'll see you again soon.
See you later, guys.